We're at the start of a tectonic shift with self-driving cars.
There are enormous opportunities to take advantage of the technological advances to greatly reduce the number of fatalities and injuries on our streets and highways, and that's what we're excited about, to see how that can happen.
And it's powered by artificial intelligence and massive data. And so when we think of data, and we think of data certainly with autonomous cars and car design, the truly exciting thing for me is that I don't think we've scratched the surface with what the notion of transport in the future means.
Data is the essential element that connects the sensors of the nervous system of an autonomous car with the muscles of the control system of an autonomous car, and ultimately controls how it moves through traffic. That data can be used and analyzed over time to develop better methods for driving, better methods for autonomous cars to respond and recognize the obstacles that might come in its path.
Already, a lot of us have task-level autonomy, where the car will park itself. Just a few years ago, that would have been a shocking, almost astonishing thing. Ultimately, it's going to get to the place where, for freeway driving, you just sit back and you relax, and so we just don't need to worry about driving. And I really like the idea that you might go to the theater in the evening, and you get out of the car and you say to the car, "I'll be done in 2 hours, come back, pick me up then." And it just drives off, and you don't need to find parking downtown. There's none of this, where do I leave my car? Because the car can take care of itself.
And the benefit of autonomous cars is that they don't really get distracted. They don't get tired. They don't get frustrated. They're not susceptible to road rage or erratic driving behavior. So with autonomous cars, we innately have a safer, more consistent way for vehicles to move through traffic, which provides for a much safer way to travel.
So how does data play into this? There are two ways, depending upon the architecture that's used. One architecture is the car with extensive sensors to sense what's around it, and that will create its own data needs. Another architecture is cars that are communicating with the infrastructure or with other cars, so that the cars will know where the other cars are, and that will have a separate set of data needs.
You end up with this swarm of sensors and vehicles that are learning, constantly learning, but you end up with this massive network of data capture implements that's being fed into the cloud. I have no idea what we're going to do with that data, but that's the bit that I would implore anyone thinking about this. You start looking at industry as a whole and not just transport, and the power of data and artificial intelligence powering that world where anybody can make anything, anytime, is like wildly exciting.